to get a whammy. $5,000.
Today, these three players are after big bucks, but they'll have to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting game of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter Tamarkin.
Thank you, Rod. Welcome, everybody, to Press Your Luck. As you know by now, we are truly the most competitive game in television. And now let's meet the three players who are going to be pressing their luck today, starting with our first player, Eileen.
Hello.
How are you, Eileen?
Great.
Now, I understand, Eileen, that you consider yourself a cross between two people.
Oh, yes.
Who might that be?
Irma Bombeck and John McEnroe. I'm right there.
Oh, I can see
relate
it, of course.
Well.
How do you justify that?
Well, I have kind of the temperament of John McEnroe and the organization and household temperament of Irma Bombeck.
That's quite a duo. I wonder how are you on the tennis court?
Oh, great. Really good.
All right, Eileen, hope your temperament stays nice and calm, all right? Let's see Thanks. What happens. Let's meet our second player, Dave Mayo. How
Hi,
are
Peter.
You, Dave?
Nice
Fine. To have you with us. Dave, you are from where?
I'm from North Hollywood.
North Hollywood, not far away. No. And you played college football?
Yes, I was running back for a local university, California State University in Northridge.
Because you're not very big, you're kind
well,
of small.
Well, at that time I weighed about 40 more pounds than I weigh now. A lot of lifting weights, a lot of getting bigger.
You really?
Reduce once you
so you played 4 years of college football?
Yes, sir.
Did it all in 1 year, did you?
4 years.
Right. No. Good to have you with us,
Thank
Dave.
Thank you, Peter.
And our third player is Randy Musser, is that right?
Yes, that's correct.
How are you, Randy?
Fine, thank you.
Now, Randy, you are a homemaker, is that right?
Yes, I am.
And you collect some strange things. What do you collect?
Well, my husband works in traffic. He works with distribution, and I collect keychains from the different traffic carriers.
Different traffic carriers, you mean?
Yeah, like, I don't know if I can mention names.
Probably not.
But the different carriers that carry freight across the nation.
Oh, I see. So you have, how many keychains do you have?
Oh, I only have about half a dozen, but he hasn't been working there terribly long.
I see. Well, maybe one of them will open big money to press your luck.
I
Let's
hope so.
Okay?
I certainly hope so.
You all ready, players?
You bet.
You know what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask you four questions. Your correct answers will earn you spins on our big Press Your Luck game board. The more spins you have, the more money you can win. Because as you know, our board is loaded with thousands of dollars in cash, terrific prizes, and every time you stop the board like this, stop, you'll win money. I should definitely play this game. $1,250. However, you can hit a whammy. If you do that, he will come out and take away all your money and make you very sad, so you want to avoid that. All right, are you all ready to press your luck?
You bet.
Good,
you bet.
Here comes the first question. Here's one for all of you who are getting ready to throw a holiday party. According to McCall's magazine, how many pounds of ice should you have as a bare minimum for a party of 10, Randy?
40 pounds.
40 pounds. All right. If you are right, Randy, you will get three big spins. I'll take your answer and two others. Give it to Eileen and Dave. If they're right, they will earn a spin apiece. Is the correct answer 40 pounds, 5 pounds, or 10 pounds, Eileen?
10 pounds.
Eileen says it's 10 pounds. Let's go to Dave and see
I'll
what he says.
I'll agree with Eileen. 10 pounds.
10 pounds. Well, for 10 people, 10 pounds of ice.
Right.
A pound a person. Eileen gets a spin. Dave picks up a spin, and Randy doesn't get any. You got heavy drinkers at your parties.
Lots of soda.
All right. Here we go with the second question. John Kennedy was our 34th president. What is Ronald Reagan's presidential number? Dave?
38.
38. All right. Is the correct answer 38, 39, or 40, Eileen?
I'm going to go 40.
Eileen's going to go 40. We'll go over to Randy and see what she's going to go.
I'm going to agree with Eileen. 40.
40. Well, Ronald Reagan is our 40th president. Eileen picks up a spin. Dave stays at one. Eileen's going to go to two there sometime. She's going to get two. I promise Eileen will give you two. There it is. Dave stays at one, and Randy picks up a spin, goes to one. Here is our third question. This is a record. Five states plus the District of Columbia have chosen this as their official flower. What flower is it? Randy?
The rose.
All right. Is the correct answer the rose, the lily, or the orchid, Eileen?
The orchid.
Eileen says it's the orchid. Let's see what Dave says.
I'm going to say the lily.
Lily. Well, the flower chosen by five states and D.C. is the rose. Randy did it. Eileen stays at two. Dave stays at one. And Randy buzzed in. She picks up a big three and goes to four. You know those spins turn into dollars. All right, here's your fourth and final question. They've been compared to wallpaper paste. But if you're a Southerner, you've been born, bred, and burped on hominy grits. From what food do we derive the humble grit, Randy?
Corn.
Corn is the correct answer. Corn, rice, or wheat? Eileen?
Corn.
Eileen says it's corn. Dave?
Make it all three corn.
Three corn. All right. How many grits does indeed come from corn?
All right.
Eileen winds up with three. Dave winds up with two. And Randy jumps in with a big seven. All you players are going to have a chance to convert those spins into dollars at the Big Stretch of Luck game board. And we come back right after this. Players, you want to turn those spins into dollars? That's what you're here for, right? Well, we're going to do it for you. We've got prizes up there on that board, surprises, and we have $13,000 in cash just waiting for you. Also, however, there's a few whammies up there, so you want to be careful about that. Remember, each spin can bring you up to $1,500, and that's very important because the player who ends this round on top gets to play last in the final round, and that is a distinct advantage. Remember that. All right, you can pass your remaining spins at any time if you're afraid of the whammy. And four whammies will put you out of the game, and everything is at stake each time you spin. We're now going to go to the player with the fewest spins. That is Dave. With two spins, no dollars.
All right, here we go.
Let's make some money, Dave. Let's get that $1,250. Stop at $550. Good start, Dave. Gonna go again. Now he's going for
$1,500.
Stop at a motorbike. Well done. That motorbike is valued at $778, Dave. $1,328. A nice start. Let's go over to Eileen with three spins and no dollars. Let's see how she does.
And stop.
Stop. Oh. You got John McEnroe.
Okay, ooh. Let's ignore him.
You don't
him.
Care. Two spins left. We got no dollars. Are you ready to make some money,
okay.
Eileen? Now and let's get $1,500.
Ready? Stop.
Okay, Eileen. Got one spin left, no dollars, but you have two whammies. You want
right.
to be very careful. Going into round three with three whammies puts you in a distinct disadvantage. So you want to be careful with that one more spin you've got. What do you
I'd
want
like
to do with
to
it?
I'd like to pass that over
Gonna
here.
Pass it. Okay, yeah, get passed to Dave. He's the player with the highest amount of money. Dave, $13.28 at stake. It goes over to the pass column, and we've got to take it. Here it comes.
Let's go, big bucks.
Got to
big
take bucks. It, $13.28 at stake.
Now move it. Big bucks, here we go.
Stop!
$200. Wait for the right moment, Dave. 15-28, you averted that whammy's gaze. Okay. Dave's in first place. Randy, you've got seven big spins. Let's see what you can
do. Okay, big bucks, big bucks. Stop!
Stop it, big bucks! $50, the largest amount on the board. What a start, Randy. Six big spins left.
Okay,
just in her luck.
Come on, big bucks. Big bucks, stop!
Stop it, go back two spaces to $1,500. Roll. $27.50 in two spins. Five spins left. You're in first place by $1,200.
Okay, I'm going to press my luck.
Okay. $27.50 at stake.
Stop!
Stop at $650. That's $3,400 in my accounting. Four spins left. $1,900 more than Dave. One more time for $3,400 in first place. Will she hold on to it? Stop. Move one space to either $750 or $200 and a spin. Which would you have?
I'll take the $750.
$750. Money in hand. That brings you up to $4,150. Three spins left. You've got about $2,500 more than Dave. They're going to be passed. Three spins to you, Dave. Three spins. You've got to take them. Here they come to the pass column. We are past the day. Here we go, Dave.
All right, here
one
we go.
Time. 15-28 at stake.
Big
first
bucks,
place.
Big
to avert that whammy.
Stop.
Stop at earrings.
All right, earrings.
A pair of earrings, Dave, worth $650. Brings you up to $21.78. Two more spins you've got to go with. Here we go, one at a time. $21.78 at stake.
Stop.
Stop at $1,250. Wow, what a big first round. $34.28. One more spin, Dave.
God,
to pick up
here
over $700,
bucks,
you can go into first
bucks.
Place.
Big bucks.
$34.28 at stake. Stop at $500. $39.28, Dave. Eileen's got $0. And Randy, you're leading with $41.50, which, as you know, is a mighty big advantage. We'll be right back with more questions, spins, prizes, and surprises right after this. so, but I have dollars in my hand. You know why these are dollars? Because these are questions. Questions become answers, hopefully. Answers turn into spins, and spins turn into dollars. So it's not too far down the line. You make some big money. This is an important round. The player who wins the most money at the end of this round gets to take it all home and come back again tomorrow. Okay? With that in mind, here comes your first question. There it is. According to a Parents magazine study, what fraction of women think that being married isn't necessary for a fulfilling life? Dave?
50%.
50%. All right, Dave. 50%, he says, is the correct... Yeah, well, I need it, actually, Dave. Give it to me in a fraction.
Half.
All right, Dave. It's the correct answer. Half, one quarter, or three quarters? Eileen?
I'll go with half, too.
Eileen, we'll go with half. Let's go over to Randy to see what she thinks.
With those choices, I'll go with half also.
You go with half. Well, Parents magazine said that one quarter of the women studied believe being married isn't necessary. You guys are optimistic. All right. No spins. Second question. Let's pretend we start all over again. If you're like most American adults, how many colds do you catch a year, Dave?
Two.
Two. Is the correct answer two, one, or three, Eileen?
Two.
Eileen says it's two. Let's go over to Randy.
I agree, two.
Two. Well, we average two colds a year. Eileen picked up a spin. Dave buzzed in, goes to three. And Randy gets one. You guys do everything together. Either you don't answer together, you answer it all correctly. Here comes the third question. This successful fast food chain bombed out a few years ago with a pineapple and cheese sandwich creation called the Hula Burger. What burger chain was it? Randy?
I'll try Jack in the Box.
Okay. Is the correct answer Jack in the Box, McDonald's, or Burger King? Eileen?
Burger King.
Eileen says it's Burger King. Dave?
Pineapple. I'll agree with Randy. I think it's Jack in the Box.
Jack in the Box? Yeah. The Hula Burger came from McDonald's. McDonald's! Nobody gets any spins. No spins. All right, this is our last question. I want to see some big spins on this one. Are you ready for it? Okay. When college students were asked to pick their favorite and least favorite hair color for the opposite sex, what do you think they chose as their least favorite, Dave?
Red.
All right, is the correct answer red, black, or brown, Eileen?
Red.
Eileen says red with a wrinkled nose. Let's go over to Randy. What do you think?
Red.
Red. The student's least favorite hair color is red.
Right.
But what do they know? Eileen winds up with two spins. Dave Dugden goes to six, and Randy goes to two. All right. All our players will be taking those spins to the big Press of Luck game board to decide who the winner is going to be on Press of Luck. Right after this. Don't go away. It is big buck time, the time we turn those spins into big bucks, and we've got 50,000 of those big bucks up there on that board just waiting to be won. However, don't forget the whammy, he's up there too, so be very careful. Let's take a look at your monies. We've got Eileen with no dollars, Dave at $39.28. Close, but no cigar, Dave, because Randy's got $41.50, and that means, Randy, you're in first place. You're going to get a chance to play last in this, the final round, and you know that's an advantageous position. Sit back, relax. We're going to go to the player with the least amount of money. Not hard to find. Eileen, no dollars, two whammies, but you've got two spins, a couple of $5,000. You could be in first place, nothing flat.
Okay,
all right, Eileen.
Stop
at $1,400. Well done. One more spin left, $1,400, still third place. Looking for big bucks, Eileen, $2,000. $3,400, okay. We'll now go to Dave, $39.28, second place, six spins. Dave,
all right.
Big bucks are
here. Here we go,
there.
Big bucks. Stop
it all.
I'm ready, bring that money, I want them.
Well, we hadn't had many whammies. That's the first for you, Dave. Third for the whole game. No dollars.
Right,
you got five spins left. You can win it back.
Here we go. Big bucks, huh? Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $500
all right,
and a spin.
All right,
that's a free
okay.
500. Still have five spins, Dave.
All right, here we go.
Here we go.
Big bucks, huh? Big bucks. Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $12.50.
All right.
$17.50.
Come on.
Third place, four spins.
I'm going.
He's going.
Dave. Big Bucks. Stop.
Stop at $5,000. Dave spins. Dave, from last place to first place, $6,750. You've got $2,600 more than Randy. First place, four spins.
Yeah, I'm going.
You're going. $6,750 at stake. A lot of money at stake.
$2,000.
$8,750, Dave. Three spins. $4,600 more than Randy. A lot of money, Dave.
Gonna pass
him. Those three spins get passed to Randy. $4,150 is what you have, Randy. You're in second place. Dave's got $8,750, more than twice what you have, but you can see what can happen in this game. Three you've got to take, one at a time. Are you ready, Randy?
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go.
Big bucks.
$4,150 at stake. $4,000 and a spin. That brings you up to $8,150. We'll put that earn spin in the earn column. Three more you've got to deal with. Here they come, one at a time. $8,150 at stake. $500. So far, so good, Randy. $8,650 is what you've got. $100 less than Dave. One more spin you've got to take. Avert that whammy, Randy. Here we go.
Stop!
Well, everyone got a whammy. You've got your first one, Randy. No dollars, but you've got three big spins. You saw what Randy did with two spins. Three more.
Okay.
Third place. Randy, you ready?
Let's try it.
Here we go. Dave's ready. Eileen's ready.
Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $2,000. $6,750.
Gotta go.
To go, Randy.
Gotta
one
go.
More. Here we go. Make some money.
Stop.
Stop at $1,000. Randy, you're in third place with $3,000. You've got one more spin. You can either take it yourself and hope that you pick up something that gives you another spin. Even $5,000 won't be enough. You need to pick up an additional spin. If you pass that last spin to Dave and he whammies, Eileen will win the game.
I gotta take it.
Gonna take it. Randy's going for it. Dave, you ready? Randy, you ready? Here it goes. Will Dave be our champion? $2,000, and Dave is our champion for today. Congratulations, Dave. You hung in there. $8,750. We'll be right back, Dave, to find out exactly what you won right after this. Congratulations. For today's big Press Your Luck winner, Dave, with $8,750, Dave. All in cash. All in cash. Remember we talked about how spins turn into dollars? Well, you certainly proved that. How does it feel to have $8,750?
A lot better than a half an hour ago, I think.
A little nervous half an hour ago, right?
Yes.
Is it like playing football? Do you get the same kind of butterflies?
Right before the kickoff, sure. Same feeling.
And then you get into the game.
You're you cooking. Wake up and then you...
Well, you certainly cooked in this game, Dave. $8,750, congratulations. Eileen, you were kind of hexed a little bit at the beginning with all those whammies. You want to take one home
these
with
guys.
You?
These guys,
no. Oh, okay. Thanks for being with us, Eileen. Randy, you both played it well. That last spin, you had to play it that way.
Frustrating.
Nothing else you can do. I thank you both for being with us. You are not going to be going away empty-handed because we have some nice prizes for you. So, you see, it was fun today, right?
Very fun.
Where else
thank
could you come and have be whammied and laugh and have a good time and go away with prizes? Am I right?
Right.
Exactly. Dave feels good about it.
Oh,
right? Okay. Thanks for being with us. We're going to see Dave next time. Until then, remember, if the whammy sees red, he'll take all your bread. This is Peter Tamarkin saying so long for Press Your Luck. Bye-bye. In the